Hello, Raghu. Hello, everyone. Do you see my screen?
No, sir.
Okay. So one second, just waiting for the remaining students. Yes, so total of 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 students ready. Okay, so can I start the session? All of you? Do you hear me? Okay, fine. Once again, see ya. Yesterday I was waiting when power is available. So just be ready if some problem arises. So don't leave the session. Okay, so you should wait for that one. So what I was discussing yesterday. Okay, don't worry. Again, I am starting from the initial point. So Linux file system. So already I described this one. Yes, hardware. On the top of hardware, we have kernel space and we have the system call. It is the system call which is interfacing with the kernel space. And on the top of this, we have the user space. Now, already I explained all such things. So I don't want to waste the time because we have a lot of things to learn. So this is important. You two things, user space and kernel space. And so many PCB I have for different process running in the CPU. And two PCB can communicate to each other. So that is called inter-process communication. So what are the examples for IPC, which we will learn in the future? I will learn what are pipes, named pipes, shared memory, semaphores, MySQL, etc. These five. Okay. So PCB contains what? So many information, but among all, three information you need to remember: process ID, parent process ID, and file descriptor number, FD number. Okay. And FD number contains so many indexes among all. So zero index related to keyboard, that is just the in. One index related to monitor, that is just the out. Two for standard error, and three for another object, that is what file object. Okay. And in the file object table, we have at last some address that indicates the inode object. So guys, once again, this is a very, very important in the what a file system in the Linux. Okay. So four things you have: PCB, FD table, file object, and inode object. There is a mistake. Okay. So this is actually an inode object. Understand? So address of inode object is stored into the file object. And address of file object is stored into the FD table. Okay. And FD table information means this address is held in PCB. Okay. So this is the relation between each and every one. Now, this is the inner structure of that one. Okay. I'm not going to discuss this one, but I will share this one so that at off time you can visualize. Now, once again, just observe here. So already I explained this one, I think. Okay. So for each and every process, we have the FD table. It keeps track of all open files per process. Second point, guys, we have the inode table. It keeps track of data on the disks. And kernel return a file descriptor for the open create system call. So very simple. Whenever you open the file or you are creating the file, so after this, means that kernel after opening or creating, it returns the FD number, okay? And that FD number is playing very important role. Using that FD number, we can store some information into that file. We can process some process on the data on that file, etc. So FD number is important, okay? And this file descriptor is an index to user file descriptor table. User file descriptor table maintains the pointers to the inode table, and from inode, it locates the data on the file. Okay. Now, once again, just to go through all of you, because today means I want to show you just a small program for the file so that you have the interest about this one. Okay, I don't want to spend time on the theoretical aspect, but minimum theory, you must know that one. So I'm going very fast in the theory session. So anode is nothing but a data structure in the Unix style file system, which describes a file system that is object, such as a file or a directory. Each anode stores the attributes and disk block locations of that object's data. And anodes store information about files and directories, folders, such as file ownership, access mode, read, write, execute permission, and file depth. The anode object is linked with process control block. Okay, and address of anode object is stored into the file object. Don't worry, means after the session, I will share such a what a PPT slide on the what WhatsApp. Okay, so that you should study one by one. Next, guys, see here. We have so many types of files. Very important: normal files, special files, and device files. Normal files we have been already familiar. Okay, but here you have to concentrate on the remaining two. What is a special files and what is the device file? Guys, special files, all the IPC related object, that is called a special files. And device files is related to your device driver. So once again, I have the example. So see here, all these are the examples of your normal files. Means it contains text files. Also, it contains guys binary files. Means .txt, .c, .h, etc., .out, .obj, .mp3, .jpg. Okay. Also, means you have the commands. That is also files. You have the binary files. So all these belong to the normal files. Understand? Raghu and all remaining students, Anis, Susmita, Raghu, understand all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So be serious, very well, Mr. You have to learn very concentrate fully, okay? We have also a special files. So what comes in the special file, guys? So see here, it, as I told you, means we have IPC object. Okay, so all such files related to that comes into a special files. Okay, so now coming on the device files, guys. So hard disk one, hard disk two, and each and every hard disk we have some partition that is related to SDB0, SDB1, etc. We have the serial code related to what its name is, what TTY 50, 51, etc. We may have the parallel port, so denoted by the PAL port, etc. So all these are examples of the device file. Don't consider such into the normal files or into the special files. So guys, very important, you must know this one. Once again, total we have the normal files, special files, device files. Normal files already you know, special files, all the IPC object, device file, hardware related files comes into the device file. Okay, now guys, see here, which type of operation we are going to perform in the file. So create, you can create the file, you can delete, you can open the existing file, you can close the existing file, you can perform read operation on the open file, you can perform write operation on the open file, you can perform what is some modification, that is appending some information at the end of the open file. You can perform seek. What do you mean by seek, guys? Actually, seek is what? Actually, means setting the cursor position in the file. Okay. By default, it is pointing to the starting position. But we have so many system call. Using system call, you can set the position of the cursor into the file anywhere which you want. Okay. Next, we have the what is get attributes, set attributes. We can also perform the renaming of that. So all these are what a file operation, guys. Understand? So we will learn one by one each in the program. Okay. So once again, now what is the next one? Now again, very important, and don't be confused. This table shows you what all in one glance. So once again, guys. From the starting, I am telling you, I have been telling you so many times, complete the files in the C. If you don't study, okay, then you may have the problem here. If you are familiar files in the C, okay, definitely you will enjoy the session. Okay, whatever the case, just concentrate here. In the left side, it's the first column. We have the second column, we have the third column, guys. We have the first column. So first column, means F open, F close, F read, F write, F print, F scan, F gets at, F put as, all these means you are familiar from the C files. Agree or not? Do you remember or not, guys? First column information, F open, F close, already you did in the files in C. But here you are going to learn the Linux system programming. So in the Linux system programming, means a first column information, we are not touching this one. Okay, this is different thing, guys. And this is different thing. Means you, we have to focus on the second column information, that is open, create, close, read, write, lseek, dupe, etc. Also, we will concentrate on the third column, what information, open dir, close dir, read dir, mkdir, etc. guys, okay? So once again, means just for your information, whenever in the C files, if you are using the F open, F close, etc., actually, this is internally calling the open, etc. Understand? Okay, now here you are going to learn on the low level, understand? So how F open actually works, how F close actually works, okay? So once again, internally, this is calling to such a system call. Once again, guys, this is the first one, a first column functions. This is called a standard library calls or buffered input output calls, understand? What is the name for this one? A standard library calls. But in the Linux, you are going to learn the system call. This is what? System call. Once again, this is the library call and this is the system call. Understand? So this is what low level file access. A second put, guys, in the C files, for using F open, F close, etc., you have to include stdio.h header file. But in the Linux system file, you need to include the header file that is named uni. std.h, remember this is the difference. Only then you can utilize subsystem call. Once again, guys, what is the first column? This is called library calls. What is the second column? This is called the system calls. Remember, this is the difference between library call, means there is a huge difference between library call and system call. Whenever in the C files you are using any library call, actually that library call is calling some associated system call, and that system call is performing some activity. Understand, guys? Okay, any confusion? If you have any doubt, you can ask me here. Okay, Raghu, so Anis, Susmita, any doubt till now?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, okay, fine. Okay, so once again, Miss, I will share all today's slides on the WhatsApp. Just go through it, read carefully. Now, this time I am not discussing open DR, close DR. First, I want to start the minimum program, guys. Okay, so let me finish the theory session very quickly. So once again, as I discussed, Miss, this figure explains in the very good manner. In the C files, you are using the F open. What is F open? This is the library call. Now internally, F open is calling another system called open. But in the C files, you were not be familiar. But here in the Linux, it is time to understand each and everything, how F open works, how F close works, etc. So once again, total three types of call you are watching from this slide, guys. Which are first one library call, second one system call, third one kernel call. Remember this one: library call, system call, and kernel call. Now see here, guys, again in the figure you are watching, only we have the two space. One space is what? User space. Second space is what? Kernel space. So in the user space, these two comes, means library call, system call, or both comes in the user space. But what comes in the kernel space, guys? All the kernel calls comes into this category. Very important, you must understand this one. So once again, F open actually initially what calls the system call, that is what open. And again, this open system call internally invokes another kernel call, that is what is open. So this is the sequence, this is the flow. Understand, don't assume that you are using app open and a final work is done. No, this is a sequence. App open internally invokes a system call open, and open system call internally invokes another kernel call, that is the sysopen. Understand? In the same way, we have app close. So app close, whatever you tell me, guys, in case of the app close, what should be the sequence? App close should call another system call. What is the name?
Close.
Yes, close. And that close system call should internally invoke another kernel call. What should be the name for that one?
Sys close.
Yes. So this is the common thing. Sys underscore open, sys underscore close, etc. So I hope you understand this very clearly. Okay. Now I'm taking the another one, guys. Now see here. Again, see here. All such information, app open, this is related to C files. Guys, see here, this is just for your revision purpose. But I don't want to spend the time to discuss here. Are you agree or not? This is related to C files. Already you studied this one. I will share this one for your study. Okay. Miss, I'm not going to discuss this in everything. So you are familiar about what app open, it is returning some file pointed you are collecting into app open. Now you are performing some activity, again you are closing, and so many modes we have, R, W, A, etc. So I'm skipping this one, guys. Again, app read, app that you are familiar from the C files. Okay, so again I'm not discussing this one, guys. Again, app get C, app get S, related to files in the C. Now coming on the Linux system programming. Now I am discussing here one by one each and every system call. So once again, guys, you have the app open in the file C files, and here in the Linux system you have the open. You tell me, guys, what is the difference between app open and open?
App open means the library call, and open, yes, means the system call.
Okay, second point, that app open internally invokes this system call open. Got it? Again, this open system call invokes internally another kernel call. What is the name for that one? Sys underscore open. Yes. So remember this flow, this sequence. Okay. So once again, just focus here. Already, means open and create return the new file descriptor. That is minor, okay, some FD number, okay, if it successfully executes. Otherwise, if it has some error, then minus one is returned, okay? So minus one indicates there is some error, okay? The argument path name is the complete part of the file of the system. Once again, just concentrate all of you. App open, you need to pass two things, guys. What is, once again, what you need to pass? Which file name you want to open, that file name you have to pass as the first argument. And what is the second argument, guys? Mode. This is nothing but the mode. In the C files, you have the mode like A, R, W, A plus R plus W plus, like this. But here, total different things. O, R, D only, O, W only, like this. So this is what read only means. I want to open the file name.txt in which mode, guys? Read only mode means I want to only perform the read operation. If you want to perform write operation, then you have to change the second argument. Understand? Next points, guys. What is the difference between open and create? Both are similar, but there is one difference. Suppose you are passing the file name open name.txt, and assume name.txt is not available, guys. Okay, then what happens? There is a problem. So you should use the create. In this case, what happens? System will create that file which you provide. Okay. So once again, how to call this one? FD equals open, and you are passing two things, file name and mode. Okay. File name must be within the double quotes, guys. And if you have the path, okay, then you need to supply the full path. Understand? And what does this function, this system call do? This system call opens that file. After opening, what happens? It returns the FT number, a file descriptor number, if successfully done. Otherwise, and what happens? The minus one is returned as an error. So whatever the case, means you are collecting that information into the FT. FT is the variable of which variable, of which data type int data type, okay? So very first, before performing your activity, what you have to do in the program, guys? First, you have to check FT contains minus one or not. If it contains minus one, then you have to stop the program, yes or no? Because there is an error. Okay, but if FD contains some valid information, then you can proceed further. Up to here, it is clear. Sushmita, Anish, Raghu, can I proceed next?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now I'm taking that. Now here, which I demonstrated about argument flags. So many arguments I have. ORT only, O append, O create, etc. Very simple, guys. See here. Suppose your file is not existing, then in this case, what happens? You should use the O_create mode as the second argument here. Then what happens? If that file is available, no problem. If that is not available, then system will create automatically with that name. Understand? So this is very useful. Now, what do you mean by the O append? O append means what? Suppose you are writing performing some write operation into that file, then what happens? Means that contents is appended at the end of that file. Okay, so you have to use the O append. What happens, guys, if you are not using the O append and simply you are performing some activity, then what happens? Your original file contents is lost. That is overwritten by the new contents. Understand? Once again, suppose you open the file and you perform write operation, adding some new data. What happens? Your original data may be lost and your new data is appended. Okay? When? In which case? If you are not using the O append as a second argument. So it is better to use the O append as the second argument, guys. Understand? So what is the benefit? Our original file is not lost. That is available. Means any new information is appended at the end of that file. So I hope it is clear. Once again, all of you tell me about when you have to use O append and when you have to use the O create as the second argument. What is the benefit for this one? Anyone tell me. Go fast. Sushmita, Anish, Raghu.
O append means we have to create in the write mode so that
very simple. Your original file is available. That is not lost. That's why. Okay. If you don't use O append, then what happens? If you perform write operation, then your original data is lost. This is the problem. Very simple, Raghu. Why you have the hesitation? Understand the remaining students, Anish and Sushmita? Getting the point about
sir, O append? Once again.
Yes,
sir. Can you explain once again?
Okay, see ya. Once again. Suppose I am not using the O append, then what happens? And I am performing some write operation if on the original file, then what happens, guys? Our original data is lost. Our new data is written into the, that is overwritten onto that file. Means I will lose our original data. This is a problem if you don't use the O append. So what is the solution? I must use the O append as the second argument here while you are opening the file. Then what is the benefit? Means our data, original data, is not lost. Any new information is appended at the end of that file always. I got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very simple. Why you are facing problem? I know. Definitely, Miss, you missed the files in the C class. Am I right or wrong? Anish, Sushmita, Raghu, did you miss the files in the C?
No, sir.
Okay, so you have to manage. Okay, what about the O create? O creator, Raghu did Anish and Susmita, either Anish or Susmita, tell me, explain me about the O create. Already I explained. Susmita, Anish, I'm waiting for your answer. Do you hear me or not?
Yeah, original file will, with using the O_RD, we can.
Yes. No, just like you, you explain me about the O create. I'm asking for the O create. O append, Raghu explain. About O create, you tell me. What is the benefit for the O_create?
If the file does not exist, it will be, we can create, sir.
We cannot, not we, but the system file will create. System will create automatically. Got my point? If that file is absent, okay, so system will create. Very simple. We concentrate 100%. You should concentrate on the class. Okay? Okay, fine, guys. Next one. So see here, so many things I have, but what I want to do means I'm not explaining, means I'm stopping the session here. I want to give you just a programming overview. Understand? Means I want to go parallelly. Theory plus program, theory plus program, theory plus program. So that class may be interactively, okay? And you can enjoy the session. Am I right or wrong? Or should I finish first theoretical concept? You tell me. You are not asking? Okay, don't worry. So let me finish this one first. So see here, so many things I have tried to understand. Govind, tell me.
Go with the simple way, sir, so that we can understand.
A program, na? Program? Program or this
sir,
one?
Whatever you told.
Okay. See here, now let me finish this one. Now see here, what you are watching here, FT equals open name.txt ORD only. Miss what? Miss what is the purpose of this one? I want to open this file in the read only. Now, using the logical operator pipe symbol, you are providing some more information. O create what SIR. Miss, we have the third argument. So see here, guys, this is nothing but the third argument. If you need, you can pass this one. Just carefully study. If you understand one, you can understand all remaining. So first one, S_IRWXU. What is the meaning of this one? R stands for read, W for write, and X for execute, and U for user. Means I want to perform on the user which operation? Read operation, write operation, and execute operation. Got my point? Or also you can use 00700. 7, throw the 7, already you know. Means what? Setting all the permission on the user. Remember from the previous lecture, 7 stands for which one? 4+2+1. That is read permission, write permission, or and execute permission. So you can use either this one or this one. So user has read, write, and execute permission. All of you understand the first one, guys? So either this one or this one you can provide. If you understand this, then you can understand the remaining one. Now you tell me about the second one. S_IRUSR. What is the purpose of this one? So very simple. User has only read permission, guys. Okay. Read permission on the user. WUSR means what? Write permission on the user. XUSR means what? Execute permission on the user. So first four. First four, it is clear or not, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you understand this first four, then you can understand the next four one. RWXG, same thing. This read, you want to set read permission, write permission, execute permission on the group. Miss, I hear some sounds, I think, from your side, guys. Just to check all of you, your audio. Now it is clear. So see here, same thing, RWX on the group. Okay, so Mr. I have 10 stamp. But see, all of you guys tell me, can I take the continuous second session?
Yes, sir.
Remaining students, Anish, Susmita, tell me, because it is allowing only 40 minutes time. So can I take another session continuously?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Because it is too late. Okay, so see here, guys, understand this one. RWXG means what? On the group, you are setting read, write, and execute permission. Now, same thing. RGRP means what? Group has the read permission. WGRP means what? Group has the write permission. XGRP means what? Group has the execute permission. So, you understand first four, you understand second four. Now, what do you mean by the last four? Again, same thing. RWX means what? Read, write, execute, but on which? User or group other. Or other? Other, yes. O stands for other. Again, same thing. Means read permission on OTH means what? Other. W means write permission on other. X means what? Execute permission on other. So, and also see here. Means you have the second technique also. Instead of 7, you can use the 4. You can use the 2. You can use the 1. So what happens? Only read permission, only write permission, only execute permission. In the same way, in the second bit position, you are setting 7. 7, 4, 2, 1. So what is the meaning one of this one? Same thing, but on the group. Okay, already you know. Third bit position related to the user. Second bit position related to the group. First bit position related to the others. Do you remember from my the previous lecture? In the past, already I explained in the file permission. You remember or not? Same thing, but here you have the extra things, materials here. So I hope this slide is clear, guys. Yes? So once again, the argument mode represents the permissions in case a new file is created using the OPAL function call using the OCreate tag. If a new file is not being created, then this argument is ignored. So this is the reason we have two prototypes for the open function call. Any of these symbolic constants can be used as mode, either the this one or this one. So I hope it is clear, guys. So once again, how many parameters you need to pass? At least 2. Okay, and okay, you can pass the third one also here. Okay, so remaining, you can understand the program. And which header file you need to include for utilizing all such system call? Open, create, read, write, all these are the system call. For utilizing such system call, which header file you need to pass? In the C files, which header file you were including in the C files?
STD.h.
Yes, but here uni STD.h. Remember. Now, what we have the next? So, see here, guys. In the program, after performing your activity, at last, you need to close that file. So, what is the syntax for this one? So, this is another system call. And only you need to supply the FD number. Remember. Got my point? What is the FD number? And when you can get the FD number? At which time you get the FD number, guys?
Sorry, sir.
At the time of creating the file, miss what? Whenever you open the system call, FD number is returned. You are collecting that FD number into some integer variable here in the previous one, guys. Here, this one I explained already. FD number is returned by this open system call. You are collecting that into the FD integer variable. Now, using this FD number, miss you will work all the activity. So again, miss. At this, what a close, which FD number you need to pass? That FD number you need to pass to this system call. So that what happens? This will close that file. So it returns 0 on success and -1 on is on the return, in case of the error. So I hope you have the clear understanding about this one. Next, what I have. So first see here. Now, see here, guys, actually, just a minute, what happens? Okay, now you tell me, guys, I open some file, at last I am closing the file. But what is the purpose of opting the file? Obviously, we may wish to do some activity on that file. Yes or no? Which type of activity you want to do? Obviously, either read operation or write operation. Yes or no? Okay. So you must know what a read system call and a write system call. Do you agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'm going to explain that read and write system call. So once again, guys, let me check how much time I have. Just a minute. Okay, don't. So I'm continuing. Just when it stops again, I will see you guys. When it stops again, I will immediately start the session. Got my point? Within the 1 minute, all of you just open, reopen that one Zoom. Okay. Now see here, very first. So I explained about the open. I explained about the closed system. But now explaining about the read and write. So see here one by one. So once again. So this is the write system call. This is the read system call. Very simple. Just you can understand yourself. So this is the syntax. Int, write. So you need to pass the FD number and const void strings buff. Buff is what I'm just explaining, and size is what something size of that one. So see again, Miss Water, just to overview, Miss about the read, about the write system call. As the name implies, what you want. Definitely using the write system call, I want to write some information into that file. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And in case of read, definitely I want to read some information from that file. Yes or no? Yes. Now, see here, guys, in case of write, you are going to write some data. So obviously that data must be available in some variable. The data which you want to write into the file, that data is available into some variable or not? Yes or no?
Yes.
So where that is available? That is available into the buff variable. Buff is the what pointer variable, which that contains that information. Okay. So write, just observe all of you the syntax. It writes the data, which data? The data which is stored into the buff variable. Okay. And how much? So this is the size. Means 2 bytes, 3 bytes, etc. How much byte you want to store? So this is the third argument, guys. And in which file you want to store? So this is the FD number. You need to pass the FD number of that file which you previously created. Got my point? So as I told you so many times, FD number plays very important role, guys. Okay, means always you need to pass the FD number for the write operation, for the read operation, for the close operation. Understand? And how you can get the FD number? Now you tell me how you can get the FD number. Anis, you tell me.
By opening.
Yes, excellent. In the first one, open. So that returns the FD number. Now later you will use such FD number. Understand? So I hope it is clear. Okay. So writes up to count bytes from the buffer, pointed buff to the file referred to by the file descriptor FD. Okay. So this is the syntax. Return cat, this is the variable, equals write FD. Hello world, and what I have the less than 1 minute up. So see here, guys, just I'm stopping, and again immediately I'm starting the session. Agree all of you? All of you agree? Okay, yes. I'm just closing and starting the session.